Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to Let's Play Gemini Rue, an adventure game by Wadjet Games and Joshua Nuernberger, which was released in 2011. This, I believe, is the original edition that you can get from GOG. I think there's an updated version on Steam for $9.99, but I really didn't want to buy it over again, you know, but it just came out like earlier this year, 2017, if you're watching this later on, so maybe you'd better off getting the Steam version. For some reason, I don't think the GOG version where I got this from has been updated, so shrug. Options. Combat is either easy or medium. I'm keeping it on medium. Portraits are on. Thank you. Voice and text, text only. I'm keeping this. This is the way it is by default. I have instead the Windows audio slider turned down to 70% so you guys can hear me. It seems more responsive than this. Even when you turn the music all the way down, you can still hear it, which is strange. Keyboard, I wanted to move some stuff around. You can't change this, I found, at all. At least I can't. Maybe the updated version has better, you know, controls. But it's interesting that I have WASD, but it's not for moving, except with this box. So hopefully, I wrote down some of this stuff. Hopefully I remember. I mean, R for reload, space for fire seems easy enough to remember. But breathe in, what is this? So there is some combat in this game. I heard it's can be a little frustrating, but it doesn't come across. You don't come across it that often. So left click, yeah, you basically walk to wherever you're going. Right click is inventory and verbs you can do on objects. Double click is interesting, which I think is a double. I'm not sure if it's a double right click or a double left click. And, well, there's little tool tips that come up in the game. I've barely played anywhere into this, so, just so you know. This is, blind, so, as usual, you know, saving and stuff. And that's it. We'll begin. There's a developer commentary. Oh, good God. Of course, we're not going to be availing ourselves of this because, well, who would play the game for the first time with developer commentary? Anyway, I heard the game in this is supremely excellent. Like one of the best in adventure games, some people are saying. So I'm eager to find out for myself. And maybe you guys can find out along with me, unless you haven't already, you know, played the game, obviously, or seen it. Joshua Nuernberger presents... Probably didn't say that right. In association with Wadjet Games.
Subject is stable. Proceed to memory wipe in T-minus 60 seconds.
Doesn't sound good.
I still don't see why we can't just let him keep this memory.
This memory?
There is no reason to let him keep the memories of his escape. Any skills he learned are kept in his cognition areas, not memory banks.
Assuming you two don't wipe those areas as well, then I'd have to retrain him all over again.
As I was saying, if they try to escape again, they'll have some pre-existing knowledge to help them get out.
If they try to escape again, don't kill them next time. She wasn't supposed to die.
Who is she?
Something's off. His breathing is starting to become irregular.
So we get some control here a little bit. He's a zombie.
Initiating memory wipe in T-minus.
Okay, here we go.
Just relax, Delta 6.
I was able to do that.
What are we supposed to do if he's conscious?
Can't get to that with these straps.
So the straps are the problem.
It doesn't matter. It'll only be a second.
I think you might want to tighten his straps. He's trying to reach out.
Don't worry about it. This'll be over in a sec.
Two. One.
What are you doing to me?
Relax, Delta 6. Just one more second.
No.
Initiating memory.
No more seconds.
Stop. Please.
I can't do that.
Just relax, Delta 6.
Yeah, that's not relaxing.
Vitals are stable.
Is he okay?
Assuming you both did your jobs correctly for once.
He's fine.
Delta 6, you're in our hands now.
Wonderful. Gemini Rue. So they're wiping his memories but keeping his skills and, I guess, other cognitive functions intact? Gemini System, Colony of Barracus, 1400 hours. That's 2 p.m. for the non-military time initiated. Weather, rainy.
Okay.
Yes, Azriel?
Something's wrong. He should have been here by now.
People change in 5 years.
He's not with the Bori Okuden anymore. I told you.
We're already an hour late. I can't stay in orbit unnoticed forever.
What do you want me to do?
Guys in orbit.
Get a new extraction point or we're getting out of here.
Alright. I'll start looking through the city. I'll probably have to ask one of the locals. He moves all the time.
Alright, one more hour. I'll be waiting.
Azriel out. Matthius Howard. Where are you?
So looking for Matthius Howard. Our name is Azriel. His name's in Kane. He's in orbit around this planet. And stuff. We got photos. Now, is that inventory or is it just communicator? Notes on meeting, I guess? I was supposed to meet Matthius, is that the way you said it? On Barracus at 1300. He never showed up. I'm en route to find his residence. Got names. I clicked on a name. Matthius Howard. I met him during the war in Gemini. He was a good friend and helped me get a job afterwards. It's been years since I've last seen him. Kane Harris, my partner for the last 8 months. Still doesn't trust me. But I don't blame him. He's currently in orbit above Barracus. His call number is 3960476. Like that.
Kane here.
Status.
How's it going up there?
Fine. Just sitting here in orbit above you. Gemini authorities still haven't noticed we're from Taurus, apparently. Just find your guy so we can do this extraction and get out of here.
So how many systems are there? We got Taurus, and we're from Taurus, and this is Gemini. Kane?
So Kane, anything new about yourself?
We just get out of here already.
Matthius.
What do you know about Matthius Howard?
Only what you told me. You were old friends in the killing business.
Never mind. Okay, so as usual, we get everything we can, look at everything we can.
People have been missing in Gemini for months now. The Bori Okuden aren't killing them, but nobody knows where they're going.
Really wonder what this Bori Okuden is.
These photos mean something to someone, not to me. I can't talk with that. No.
No. Shoot it.
I'm not going to go around and shoot everything I see. That doesn't need to be picked.
And that doesn't do much. We got this terminal as well.
Looks like a planetary terminal. Runs just like a computer. The rain must be interfering with the terminal. The screen is all staticky. Maybe a little kickstart would do it some good.
Hand, hand.
7-25, search protocol initiated.
There goes the static. For now, at least.
Now will it work?
Please log in with your citizenship ID card to access this terminal. If you are visiting from off-world, please use your temporary visitor's card you acquired in the boarding station.
Well, I guess we don't have one of those.
That doesn't make any sense here.
And we can't pick a lock on a terminal.
I'm not going to shoot it when I need to use it. I can't use that item here.
Okay. Okay, so photos. Poster.
Looking for work? Space is available at the mines. Visit your local recruitment office for info. Starting salary, $2,400 an hour.
It's a lot of money.
Propaganda.
But it's not real, it's propaganda.
I'd rather leave it for some drifting juice addict to get a life.
About this broken light.
Looks like this light's not working. There's nothing to do there.
Can I kick that and make it work?
I can't do anything there.
Guess not. Anything else to look at? We have photos. I thought I saw another poster, like, around here. I guess not. The exit. Broken light. Address.
4382. Somebody in this poor world will come along and need to find this address one day. I wouldn't want to put them in further misery.
Oh, I had to mess it up.
It probably leads into a back alley. It's locked. Doesn't budge.
Nah.
I don't see how I can use my mouth there.
Okay, so we got an exit. Wanna make sure there's nothing else to look at, no? What if I look at an exit? No, huh?
The maintenance ladder goes down into the trash compactor.
Trash? I don't want to go down there, not yet anyway.
City side dump. They'll probably ship it out in a week.
Trash heap. Anything else? That looks like we can maybe climb in there. Okay. Now, I've been here and looked at some of the things on this screen, and after that, we're all blind. Just so you know, guys. Some of the stuff I haven't even looked at in here, like the sign.
No parking. I can't do anything there.
Kick it.
I don't need to get in a fight.
With a sign?
Probably homeless. I'm not here to pick a fight.
Can we talk to him?
Hey. Hey.
Hey,
you're
hey.
Not going to have any luck with him. Either they're totally spaced out from the juice withdrawal, or they're too weak to talk.
Thanks for the info.
I'm not here to pick a fight.
Shoot him?
I'm not going to shoot him.
Alright, so...
4384.
He literally just says numbers. 4384. 4382. Got it. So we're going up as we go this way.
Must be desperate for money to be out on a day like this, in a city like this, in a galaxy like this.
So what I don't know is... the character we're playing here, Azriel, is he the same guy from the beginning, the intro? Look forward to finding out, or is that somebody else?
I don't want to get in a fight.
Yeah, we won't poke him. We'll just talk to him.
Hey.
Hi there. What are you doing out in the rain? You could catch pneumonia. Don't you know you should be indoors? It's a mining day.
I gotta say, I think this voice actor phoned it in. This guy here. What about this beggar?
What's with the beggar?
Just another juice addict suffering from the low supply.
It literally just sounds like he's reading it off of a piece of paper. Kane?
I don't need to talk about Kane here.
Okay. Matthias?
I'm looking for someone.
Did you check the planetary database?
What?
They have terminals all over the city. You should check them out. They might be able to tell you something.
I already checked one, but I can't use it without an ID card.
You from off-world or something?
Mm-hmm. Let's tell the truth.
Yeah, police business. We had to bypass the docking ring.
You're not from this system, are you? Don't worry. I won't report you. Things have been bad since the war. We need any help we can get to turn things around. Well, I'd like to help against the Boyokuden in any way I can. So I guess you could borrow my card if you really need it.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Yep, okay. Examine. That's funny, so we can't look at an inventory item unless we go over something that can be examined, but instead go like this. Name, Gerard Branier. Age 31. Credentials, teaching doctorate. Immigration status revoked. Alright, that lets us look at the communicator.
One of the few items I have left from my old life.
Right. A memory we had forgotten?
My IMI Jericho 941. Better than the useless revolvers the Force wanted to give me. I don't need to talk to him right now.
Okay. So I pretty much messed around with this phone booth and that was it.
Luckily, I have my own communicator. If I needed to use a phone, I can use my communicator. The door is in perfect working order. I can't use my mouth here.
Why not? It's a telephone. Alright, so... shop?
You'd have to be desperate for a buck to street vend in a place like this. If I need something, I can ask the vendor.
I guess we don't need anything.
I don't need to talk to him right now.
Exactly.
There's no reason to kick them.
Alright, so I got the sign, the beggar. Back alley. Alright, we got the door and we can go into the back alley.
I don't know where it leads.
That's half the fun.
Locked.
Kick it.
Nothing.
Hello?
Anybody home?
Alright.
I should ask the locals for help. There's no use getting lost.
Okay, we don't want to go that way. So, unless we want to go in that garbage heap, we're going this way. Blind territory from here on in, guys.
I don't know where to go. I'm better off looking for him here first.
Oh, okay. Guess we're going back to that communicator. Not communicator, terminal. Right-clicking on it or pressing C. Alright. We don't have any new names. So we can use the card on this terminal.
ID card accepted.
Yay!
Matthias Howard, where are you, old pal? I've jacked in my communicator, so I can reference names and notes.
Sweet. Planet Barracus, terminal city of Pittsburgh.
I can also open it to drag names directly from my communicator and into the search box for convenience.
Drag names from my communicator into the search box, okay. Well, let's check out the news. December 14th, 2229. Oh, that's at least close to the year. Probably is the year. Reports of syndicates getting shut down and juice dealers thrown out of business have reached Gemini. Reportedly, an ex-assassin who worked with the Boryokuden has been feeding information to the Taurus police, prompting the fight against crime. Gemini jurisdiction, however, prevents him from coming here. Wondering, is that us? Now, there's no other... Okay. Want to make sure there's no other... Wait. Terminal help. Perform your search in the box above. Results will be listed on the left. You may search for any type of planetary information. You may also use the world map at your convenience. If you need additional assistance, the icon in the top right corner is there for your help. Yes, which is the one I just clicked. Oh, wow. Oh, we can zoom in with plus? Wait, hold on a second. Or I click on it. Okay, that's our top level. So this is Planet Barracus, but we've named all these places after, you know, cities on Earth. Cool. System of Gemini. We've got Colony 4, Harmony, and there's Barracus. How far can we zoom out? That's as far as we can zoom out. Now, can I click on any of these things and look at them? No? No, not even Barracus. Too bad you can't, you know, interact with it. So, District 6. Alright. I might want to keep track of these addresses after a while, these numbers at least. That didn't work. I'm supposed to drag the name. Oh, this is our search here. Oh, because I was pressing plus for the map. Kane Harris. No matches. Matthias Howard. One match found. Age 35.
Hibiscus High Rise. I have no clue where that is. Should probably look it up as well.
Okay. He has a job. He's a PH engineer. Is that like a physics engineer or literally PH, like PH balance? Like in water and such. Alright, I don't suppose I can look that up, no. Hibiscus? Hibiscus. Two matches found, District 7. Huh. District 7 was established in Pittsburgh in 2182. As the need for residency spiked due to the mineral migration. It is also the site of the Battle of Garner's Paw in the Gemini War, where the rebels warded off the invaders. Hibiscus. Item added to notes. Cool. Useful information, such as addresses, will automatically be added to your notes. You can check your notes. Communicator. 4390 Brookview Avenue. Oh, cool. We get to look up lore and stuff. I love it. The Gemini system, settled in 2157, is composed of three planets around a central dwarf star. Gemini was one of the two colony systems under Taurus control until it broke free during the Gemini War, which is 2217 through 2220. Since then, Gemini's economy has faltered and a new government has slowly been established. What about the Gemini War? Wait, here it says 2216 to 2219. Instead of 2217 to 22... What? Okay, we're off a year with these dates. Whew, sorry guys. Established Gemini independent from Taurus and Pleiades. Initial cause, assassination of Silas Brannier, Union leader. The war gradually moved from the occupation of Gemini territories into insurgent bombings on Taurus planets. Results, Gemini independence and the establishment of a free government. Harmony was settled in 2157 along with Barracus as the major planets in the Gemini system. Politically, it is the center of Gemini, but not economically. It currently houses the majority of all Gemini bureaucracy. Barracus is the gas giant discovered in 2157 and settled for its valuable commodity of elements that compose basic engine fuel. Its main cities are Pittsburgh, Harrisburg, Cleveland, and Charleston. Wait, we're walking around on a gas giant? So I find that hard to believe. Gas giants are uninhabitable. Colony 4, settled 2195, was terraformed much later than Barracus and Harmony. It is mainly used as a farming world and as a jumping point between Pleiades and Gemini. Let's see how much information we can find here. Sorry guys, it's hard to see what I'm typing because these letters are so weird. Pleiades, actually. Lai, I guess, colonized 2166, is used as a drilling planet. The majority of manufacturing space parts takes place underground, safe from sub-zero temperatures. Pleiades is composed of two planets, so in 2166, Lai and Colony 3. It is currently under Taurus control and is scarcely traveled. Colony 3 was settled in 2166 along with Lai in the Pleiades system. Like Lai, Colony 3 never fully developed into a bustling economic center. Today, it still encounters trouble trying to increase its population. About Taurus. New Earth, look at that. Taurus, cell 2144, earlier, is the central hub of the New Worlds. Its primary worlds are New Earth, New Jupiter, and the failed Colony 2. Oh, this is interesting. Sorry guys, I hope you don't mind if I read about this a little bit more. New Earth was the first planet colonized in the New Worlds. It is home to over 1 billion citizens. All trade, economy, and politics are centered there, or here. New Jupiter was the second planet to be colonized in the New Worlds. Currently is home to over 200 million citizens. Those who wish to go to somewhere less crowded than New Earth come here. If it's anything like real Jupiter, you can't live there, but... We're on a gas giant, apparently, so I don't know. Colony 2 was the site of an unsuccessful terraforming operation around 2210. The majority of the planet's population was evacuated in time, but many were left to perish. Most of the refugees were shuttled to New Jupiter for safe haven. Okay, so what about regular Earth? We only have New Earth. Gemini. Granier. Wait. History teacher. Age 36, District 4, apartment. He's related to Silas Brannier. Who did we get the ID card from? Pittsburgh without an H. New Pittsburgh is the central hub of the planet Barracus, along with the lesser cities Cleveland, Charleston, and Harrisburg. I don't know if I have anything to say about these other places. New Cleveland is the main outpost into the wastelands of the planet Barracus. Hold on a second. What's the other ones? Harrisburg? Central docking port of the planet Barracus. And there's one more, isn't there? This entry tells us all of them. Charleston. Charleston Chew. New Charleston is the central airfield of the planet Barracus where the majority of aerial traffic comes in. Okay. Now, what about these districts? Too many results. District. Ah. District 1. Aren't we in like 6? We're in 6. District 6 is a primary residential zone mostly populated by miners who work on the outskirts of town. District 6 apartment. Item added to notes. I don't even know what it is. District 6 apartment, 3384 Hollister Drive. I just found that randomly. Not destruct. Do we try 4? District 7 was established in Pittsburgh in 2182 as the need for residency spiked due to the mineral migration. It is also the site of the Battle of Garner's Paw in the Gemini War, where the rebels warded off the invaders. Garner's Paw, huh? District 8. I'm just going to try District 9. Yeah, I guess we're not concerned with that. Garner's Paw. No matches found. No, okay. Okay. Guess we're done. I search for Hollister in Brookview. There's a Hollister in Brookview. Let me just look for those two and we're done searching right now. Did I type it wrong? Brookview, we got this hibiscus. Hollister? I'm sure I spelled that right. Alright, I guess we're done. Well, we got new stuff in the communicator, apparently. The address for Hibiscus High Rise is 4390 Brookview Avenue. Okay.
I was right. He does live around here. I think I can make it on foot.